In the last class, we have started our discussion on phase detection, and we saw that after applying AdaBoost algorithm, we can reduce the number of features or number of weak classifiers to around 2,500. Okay, so from 160,000 features, we can reduce the features to 2,500 weak classifiers or features. Then we go for linear weighted linear combinations of these weak classifiers, and we obtain a strong classifier. Now this algorithm describes all these steps of AdaBoost algorithm. And now, after having the AdaBoost algorithm, now we have around 2,500 features for linear combinations. Now, the next step is cascading step. Now, what is the basic principle of the algorithm? So, basic principle of the algorithm to scan the detector many times through the same image, each time with a new size. Okay, now the problem is that when we go for linear combination of weak classifiers, now we don't know how many hard features or how many weak classifiers are corresponding to a non-face or the objects which are not having the face image. Okay, so now what we do, we increase the complexity and divide the total number of reduced features or the hard features into a number of stages. Okay, that means after applying AdaBoost algorithm, we obtain around 2,500 hard features. Now this 2,500 hard features will now be divided into a number of stages. Okay, and each stage correspond to a strong classifier. Now why we are dividing this hard features, 2,500 hard features, into a number of stages? Because here each stage correspond to a strong classifier, and so we have to obtain a face in the image. Therefore, each stage will test or determine whether the image that we are feeding to the algorithm will contain the face image or not, or some part of the or a part of the face image or not. Okay, so here each stage will determine the part of face or the whole face which will be present in the image. Okay, now so this diagram represent the cascading of different stages. So if we consider there are n number of stages, then each stage will determine. So in the input we feed the image. Okay, then since this n number of stages will be having 2,500 hard features or weak classifiers, and every stage represent the strong classifier. Okay, that means every stage will have certain number of weak classifiers or certain number of hard features. So these hard features are potential hard features. Potential hard features means that that hard features may represent some facial features or the part of a face. That is why these hard features are considered into the linear combinations of weak classifiers. Okay, now there is a problem that when we divide the the 2,500 hard features into a number of stages or number of strong classifiers, then we don't know which features will go to a particular particular stage for linear combination. Okay, so here is a problem that when we select the hard features, when we select the weak classifiers for linear combinations for each stage, then to which stage, which hard feature or which weak classifier will go for linear combination, that cannot be determined. So that can be done heuristically or randomly, randomly we can do that task. But Heulogen's introduce a heuristic approach by which the hard features will be selected for each stage or each strong classifier that will accept the input image, and whenever some input image will accept the first stage, so that first stage will determine whether that image is having any part of face image or not. If the image is having a face image, then the first stage will pass the output to the second stage. That means that that image may contain a face, okay, or part of face. So that image will pass to the second stage. So second stage is another strong classifier. So second stage again determine whether that image is containing a face image or a part of face image or not. If that image will not contain the face image based on some criteria, then it will be rejected. Okay, that means the image will be rejected at non-face. That means that image is not containing any face image or a part of face image. So how this criteria is determined? So Viola-Jones introduced a heuristic approach. So in heuristic approach, here they consider two different performance metrics. One is called the true positive rate, and another is called false positive rate. In the false positive rate, it is to be determined that how many non-faces are accepted by the algorithm as face images. Okay, and true positive rate means how many faces are accepted by the algorithm as a true face. So these two performance metrics are used by Viola-Jones, and for every stage, this true positive rate and false positive rate is fixed. That means if we consider there are 200, there are 100 face image and 100 non-face image, then we will fix the false positive rate. That means we can fix the false positive rate 0.5. Okay, so 0.5 means the 50% 50% non-face may be accepted by the stage one, and all the faces, that is the 100%, that is one. If the probability is one, then that means the 100% or 100 face images will be accepted by the stage one. That means this is the criteria. So this performance matrix will have some value. Based on this value or based on this criteria, the stage one will pass the image to the stage two. Okay, that means for every stage, the true positive rate and false positive rate will decide whether the incoming face can be accepted as a potential potential image for having the face, or it may be rejected at non-face. Okay, so that means every stage will have this criteria with true positive rate and false positive rate. So until and unless we meet the criteria, the image will be rejected as non-face. So whenever the criteria will be met, then only the stage one will pass the image to the stage two. Okay, and stage two, similarly stage two will have the same criteria, and whenever the criteria will be met by stage two, then only the image will be passed to the stage three, otherwise it will be rejected as non-face. Okay, so by this n number of stages or n number of strong classifiers, we can determine the image as a face, or if it is not a face, then in the earlier stages it may be rejected as a non-face. Okay, so this is the cascading. In the cascading step, we have a number of stages or number of strong classifiers that will contain a certain number of every stage will contain the certain number of hard features or weak classifiers, and these weak classifiers are combined together in terms of weighted linear combination of hard features or weighted linear combination of weak classifiers. Okay, and here heuristic approach is used to determine whether the image is containing the face image or not. If it is containing the face image, then it will be passed to the next stage, otherwise it will be rejected as non-face. Okay, so cascading is the last operation or last step in Biot-Legendre's algorithm. In the next the next topic that we are going to discuss is YOLO object detection algorithm. This YOLO object detection algorithm is a generalized algorithm. So this YOLO object detection algorithm can be customized for face detection algorithm also. Okay, so I have used a source, that is Barclay SCET. So I have used this source to prepare my presentation. So you can get all the information if you want to study on this algorithm, YOLO object detection algorithm. So you can go for this source, and you can have more materials on this object detection algorithm. Now, what is YOLO algorithm? YOLO, the full form of YOLO algorithm is you only look once. That means this is the one shot algorithm. So what is one shot algorithm? I will come to that point later. Let us consider what is classification and what is object detection. So classification means we label the object after classification. Okay, so if we want to classify the objects with some annotation or label, then after classification we get the label as annotation, or we get the object as their names after classification in object detection. So multiple objects will be there, one or multiple objects will be appeared in the image. So we have to detect the objects in the image. So we can detect the objects in the image by bounding box. Okay, so we can make a bounding box for an object in the image. If we have multiple objects in the image, then we can have the multiple bounding box for the number of objects which are appearing in the image. Okay, so this is the difference between classification or object detection. So in object detection, we don't need to classify the objects from one object to another object. Here we are just making a bounding box to detect that object. In classification, After classification, we classify one object from another object by assigning label or assigning annotation for each object. Now there are some naive approaches. So one of such naive approach is, if we consider this image, then we can scan the image with sliding window. Sliding window means we can have a small size of subregion in the image, and number of sub we can have a number of subregions for each image. If we consider this image, then sliding window will have some certain number of rows and certain number of columns, and the certain number of rows and columns will decide the dimension of the sliding window. Okay, and the sliding window will be used to scan horizontally or vertically the image. Okay. Now in the next step, what we do, when we detect every sliding windows on the image, then each and every sliding window will be feeding to a convolutional neural network classifier. Okay, so we use a classifier that is called convolutional neural network classifier. Now we can feed the images into a classifier model to predict a label for that region. That means whether this image will contain some object or not. Okay, so it may be a person, it may be some other object. So each and every sliding window is detected by the classifier model. Okay, so here the classifier model is the CNN. So you can use the CNN to get the information about the object which is provided in the image. Okay. Now naive approaches are slow approaches. So these are not the first algorithms. So we can have the better algorithm that is called a region based convolutional neural network. So we can use the region based convolutional neural network. So this algorithm is much faster than the naive based approach. Okay, or naive approach. So strategically we can select the interesting regions to run through the classifiers. So in RCNN we can select the interesting regions. Interesting region means the potential regions which may have the objects in the image. That means all the regions we cannot fit to the classifier model. We can only fit the interesting regions or the potential regions which may have where there is a chance to have the objects in those interesting regions or in those potential regions. Now what is done in YOLO algorithm? So we can make prediction on many regions of an image, but YOLO passes the entire image at once into a CNN. Okay, so that is why it is much faster, because that is why it is called one shot algorithm. In one shot algorithm, that means the entire image is only entire image is passed to the classifier model, that is CNN, at once. Okay, and here the CNN predicts the labels, bounding boxes and confidence probabilities. Okay, so on the left hand side you can see the input image. So after passing through the convolutional neural network, it produces the confidence probability, the bounding box and the label. Okay, now what is the confidence probability? Confidence probability means we can have a number of estimated bounding box. Now every bounding box correspond to, or every bounding box carries a confidence probability. Now for which bounding box we will get the confidence probability high, then that bounding box will contain the entire object or the maximum part of the object in that bounding box. Okay, so when we pass this input image through convolutional neural network, we can have the labels, we can have the bounding boxes, we can have the confidence probabilities. That means for a single object we can have a number of bounding boxes, and these bounding boxes are also known as anchor boxes. Okay, anchor boxes. And we can predict the number of anchor boxes for a single object in the image. So now for every bounding box or every anchor box, we can have the confidence probability. Now for which bounding box or for which anchor box we have the highest confidence probability, that means that the corresponding bounding box will contain the entire object or the maximum part of the object. So what are the different steps in YOLO algorithms? Now the first step, we divide the image into a number of cells. Okay, so we can divide the image into cells with an S by S grid. Okay, so size of each grid or each subregion will be S by S dimension. That means S number of rows, S number of columns. That means the square subregion. Okay, so here we divide the entire image into square subregions. Now in the second step, so each subregion or each grid predict B bounding boxes. Now if we consider B is 2, okay, B is 2, that means there will be 2 bounding boxes, and these bounding boxes may overlap with the bounding boxes of the other subregion or the other grid. Okay, now if we have 2 bounding boxes for each grid or for each subregion, then for every bounding box we'll have a center. Okay, and this center is denoted by a dot. That means here you can see every bounding box is having a dot in the center. Okay, and based on this center we can detect the objects here. Okay, now this cell is responsible for detecting an object if the object's bounding box falls within the cell. Okay, so in the second step we can have the bounding boxes, number of bounding boxes. So if there are multiple objects, then we can increase the number of bounding boxes up to 5. Okay, but here in this example you can see the number of bounding boxes are 2. Okay, that means for every grid or every subregion we will have 2 bounding boxes, and for every bounding box we will have a center, and this center is denoted by a dot. Okay, and for some bounding boxes may share the region with other grid or other subregion. Okay, now these bounding boxes have a confidence probability. Okay, now that means every bounding box will have a confidence probability. Now if we set a threshold for this confidence probability, then whenever we found the confidence probability for a bounding box is greater than the threshold, then we can say that bounding box is containing the object. Okay, so here we can see an example where the threshold is set to 0.9. okay, now there is an object like car, and this car is containing by a grid or subregion. Okay, and the corresponding confidence probability is 0.93, and for this bounding box the confidence probability is found to be greater than the threshold 0.9. therefore we can conclude that this bounding box or this anchor box is having the object, okay, the object card. So therefore we can set the threshold depending upon the confidence probabilities that are determined from all the bounding boxes which are obtained on the number of grids or number of subregions on the image. If we have multiple objects, then we can set the bounding boxes up to 5. Otherwise, one bounding box or two bounding boxes is sufficient to detect the object, a small number of objects in the image. Now, how to encode these bounding boxes? Now, here we can use a simple example where there are 3x3 cells. Okay, so on the left hand side, you can see an image where we have 3x3 cells. That means this image is divided into 9 subregions or 9 grids. Okay, so here S equals to 3, and each cell predicts one bounding box. Okay, so here each cell is predict one bounding box, and objects are here dog equals to 1 and human equals to 2. That means we assigning the class level 1 to dog, okay, and 2 to human. Now for each cell, CNN can predict a vector y. Now what is y? Now when this image will pass through the convolutional neural network, then that CNN will predict a vector y. Now what is y? So here y is a vector which will be containing the probability of the bounding box, okay, that is denoted by PC, then the coordinates of the bounding box center. That means if the center is denoted by the big dot, then that center will have the x coordinate, y coordinate, okay, and this center is denoted by x coordinate, y coordinate, that is bx and by, okay. Then we can have the height of the bounding box and width of the bounding box, that is bh and bw, and c1 and c2 represent the class levels of dog and human, okay. So this is the so we can have the probability the cell contains an object that belongs to class 1 or class 2, so given the bounding box contains an object, okay. So that means we will have the 7 elements. One is the probability of the bounding box, okay, x coordinate, y coordinate of the center of the bounding box, then height and width of the bounding box, okay, and class level of the objects. If we have one number of objects, then depending upon that, we can have that much number of class levels. If there are 5 objects, then we will have C1, C2, C3, C4, and C5. So class levels will be there, and all will be included in the Y vector. So here Y is a column vector, and in this column vector is produced when the input image is passing through the CNN classifier. Okay. Now, when we have multiple bounding box, in the earlier case, in this case, we have considered only one bounding box. Now, we are increasing the bounding boxes. Now, we have multiple number of bounding boxes. Now, if we have multiple number of bounding boxes, then when this image will be passed through the CNN, then CNN will produce two bounding boxes. One is indicated by the blue color, and another is indicated by red color. Okay. Now these bounding boxes, these two bounding boxes will have certain number of rows and certain number of columns. That means the height and width. There will be an height and width. Okay. So the corresponding vector, Y vector, will be containing more number of elements. So previously we considered one bounding box, and for one bounding box There are four elements, that is the x coordinate, y coordinate, height and width. Now we are considering, now we are considering, we are considering another confidence probability for the second bounding box. Okay, along with that, we will have the x coordinate, y coordinate of the center of the second bounding box and the height and width of the second bounding box and the class levels C1 and C2. Okay. Now here, CNN will predict a y for each cell. So the size of the output tensor, that is the, here tensor means the multidimensional matrix. So tensor means the multidimensional matrix. This tensor can be created, but tensor cannot be updated. Okay. So once tensor is created, tensor cannot be updated. So here tensor means the multidimensional matrix. So here the multidimensional matrix can be represented by S by S. So here S by S is the grid dimension into 5B plus C. Why 5B plus C? So here Y has 5B plus C. Why 5B plus C? Can someone tell me why 5b plus c? Why will contain 5b plus c elements? Yes, c is the number of classes. S by s means the number of subregions or number of grids on the image. Okay. Any idea?
Sir, all the properties of the a single matrix which we have produced for one what we say for one y, for each y there are exactly those five different b's, like the width, size and all, for it is there for all of the what we say matrix. That's why.
Yes. That means here we are considering the center of the bounding boxes, that is x coordinate, y coordinate. Okay. And then here we have the probability, confidence probability. So along with the confidence probability, we are considering the x coordinate, y coordinate of the center of the bounding box and height and width. Okay. And here's capital C is the number of classes, total number of classes. Okay, so S by, so the corresponding tensor becomes S by S into 5B plus C. Now what is the operational step of YOLO algorithm? So here we can see that if we consider the color image, so color image will have a certain number of rows and certain number of columns. Along with that, color image will be having three channels, because in grayscale image we have only one channel. One channel means, what is the difference between grayscale image and color image in terms of the number of bits that are required to represent the grayscale image and color image?
So the value of per pixel.
So how many bits will be required to represent one pixel in color image and in the grayscale image?
Sir, for black and white it would be like 0 and 1 for black and white, and for the color we need 3.
No, black and white means binary image. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And grayscale is not a binary image.
So that's normalized, no, sir?
Binary image is one image, okay? Grayscale is another image. Color image is another image.
Yes, sir. Color image has 3 pixel value for each, a block. For each block, we have 3 pixel values for R, B, and G.
No. What will be the word size in the register? If we consider register to store the corresponding bit of a pixel, okay? Then how many bits will be required for a pixel in the grayscale image?
Sir, I guess 3.
Why 3? Why not 8? 8 bits. What size will be 8 bits? in the register.
Means sir, for each zero and other left are
yeah,
zeros,
if
sir.
we if we if we say if we say the gray level value is gray level value is 31, so how 31 will be represented in the register? How you will store the 31 on a computer memory? If we consider RAM, okay, so how many bits will be required to store a pixel value, that is the intensity value, in the register? 8 bits will be required,
yes,
isn't
sir.
it? 8 bits will be required. Now for color image, since the color image is having 3 channels, okay, red, green, blue, RGB, this is called RGB image. There are 3 channels, red, green, blue. Now for every channel, we require 8 bits for every pixel in the color image. Okay, since there are 3 channels, therefore 24 bits will be required to store 1 pixel of the color image. Okay, so there, that means here if we consider W is the width, L is the height, and 3 is the number of color channels in RGB. Okay, now this, when this color image will be passed into the convolutional neural network, then there will be a series of convolutional and pooling layers, because every convolutional neural network is divided into 3 stages. In the first stage will contain the convolutional layer, the second stage will contain the pooling layers, and third stage will contain the classifier. Okay, third stage will contain the classifier. That means in the third stage we classify the objects, or we classify the pattern, and then we assign the class level to that pattern or to that object. Okay, so convolutional layers, pooling layers, and then classifier. So here whenever this color image will be passed through the convolutional neural network, so there will be a series of convolutional and pooling layers. So after passing through this series of convolutional and pooling layers, this color image will generate a tensor. Tensor means a multidimensional array will contain s by s. That means this multidimensional array represent this matrix s by s in s by s by 5b plus c. Okay, so this is the multidimensional matrix that will contain in this tensor, and this tensor is produced after passing the color image to the convolutional neural network. And then not only the tensor is produced, but also the bounding box and the confidence probabilities. Okay, now here we will measure the performance of the predicted bounding boxes. Now here you can see an image on the left hand side, and one bounding box is labeled as ground truth, another bounding box is labeled as predicted bounding box. Okay, now what is ground truth? Now when we develop a YOLO algorithm or YOLO object detection model, in that YOLO object detection model we have to train that model. That means initially when we develop the model will be considered as the novice. That means that model doesn't know anything about the objects. Okay, we have to make understand the model to predict the objects correctly. Okay, so that's why we need to feed the model with so many, with large number of examples of objects. Okay, now when we feed large number of objects for training, then only we give the then we give the correctly predicted object. That means that correctly predicted object will be called the ground truth. That means that model will be trained with the ground truth of objects. Okay, so that is why whenever some image is provided for predicting the object in the image, then that image will contain the predicted bounding box. So predicted bounding box is not maybe the actual bounding box that may match with the ground truth, or that may not be match with the ground truth. Okay, so whenever we train the model, we have to use the ground truth. Ground truth means exactly predicted object. We have to feed the model to train that model for prediction. Okay, so here for measuring the performance, we use a performance matrix that is called union over intersection. Okay, and this union over intersections measures the overlap between two bounding boxes. Two bounding boxes means one bounding box is ground truth, another bounding box is predicted bounding box. That means the image that we have fed to the CNN, so that will predict some bounding box, and that bounding box will be compared with the ground truth. That means how much the predicted bounding box or the estimated bounding box is making closer to the ground truth. That means whether they are matching correctly or not, or how much they are matching. Okay, so how much the predicted or estimated bounding box is found to be close to the ground truth. So that is to be measured by union over intersection performance matrix. Now during training, we calculate this union over intersection measures between a predicted bounding box and the ground truth. Now what is union over intersection? Union over intersection is equal to area of intersection divided by area of union. That means we can find the area of union between ground truth and estimated bounding box. Okay, then we can also find the intersection. Now the area of intersection divided by area of union. Okay, so this can be denoted by the union over intersection measures. Now here we have the three examples. Here you can see at the below of this slide. So we can have the poor union over intersection measures. We can have the good union over intersection. We can have excellent union over intersection. In case of excellent, we can see that the two bounding boxes are coincides with each other. Okay, but in case of good bounding boxes, here we can see that most of the predicted bounding box is matching with ground truth. That means a small part is not matching, but most of the part is matching with the ground truth. But in case of the first example, that is the poor bounding boxes, that 50% is matching, 50% is not matching. So this case can be considered as the poor matching. Okay, so we can classify these measures into poor, good and excellent groups. Okay, now here we will find the non-match suppression. Okay, non-match suppression, what is non-match suppression? So sometimes the same objects will be detected multiple times. So when this situation is arise, when we have multiple number of estimated bounding boxes, okay, then only we can have the multiple number, we can detect the object multiple times. That means for the same objects we have a number of bounding boxes. Now which bounding box will be selected as the final bounding box, which will contain the entire object or the most or the maximum part of the object? Okay, so this is called the non-max suppression. So in the non-max suppression, the bounding box which is having the confidence probability is highest than that of the other bounding boxes, then we can expose that bounding box which will be having the entire object, and the bounding boxes which are not having the confidence probability that much of high, then we will go for the suppression. That means those bounding boxes will be suppressed, and the bounding box which is having the maximum confidence probability will be exposed. Okay, and that is called the non-max suppression. Now the non-max suppression solves multiple counting by removing the box with the lower confidence probability. When the union over intersection between two boxes with the same level is above some threshold. Okay, so here we can have an example where we identify the box with the highest confidence. Okay, so we can have three probabilities. One is 0.95, another is 0.82, another is 0.41. Okay, union over intersection, one can have 0.62 and 0.47. Now we can calculate this union over intersection between highest confidence box, each of the other boxes. Now we suppress boxes with union over intersection above a selected threshold. Okay. So that means non-max suppression. We can have the bounding box with higher confidence probability, and that will contain the entire object. I think there is a mistake they have done here, because we will suppress those bounding boxes which are having lower confidence probabilities, and we will expose that bounding box which is having the confidence probabilities high. Now how we can implement this YOLO algorithm? Now there are some pre-trained models are available for this YOLO algorithm. So one such pre-trained model is made on COCO database. COCO database means the common objects in context. So this is very popular computer vision database of images with 80 levels objects. Okay, that means 80 level objects means there are 80 classes are present, and this 80 classes having a number of images. Okay, and this number of with that much of images that YOLO algorithm is trained. Okay, and it became a pre-trained model after training with 80 levels of objects. Now it became a pre-trained model. Okay, now if we randomly feed any image to that algorithm, okay, or to that implementation, then this some images may be misclassified, because these images are not available as a training examples in the pre-trained model. Therefore they will be misclassified, they cannot be recognized, because these are not available in the training examples in the pre-trained model. That means the pre-trained model are not aware about these images. Therefore whenever we feed some random image to the YOLO implementation, then image may not be recognized, because the YOLO implementation is not aware about these images. Okay, that means before we go for prediction or before we go for detection, we need to train that model with a large number of examples. It may be a face image, it may be some other objects. Okay, so that the pre-trained model will aware about such type of images, so that whenever there will be a task of detecting a face or detecting some other objects, then that detection will be done successfully. Okay, that means whenever the detection is done successfully, that means that pretrained model is already having that images or such type of images in the training set. So here we can have the COCO pretrained model levels. So these are the different images which are already labeled in the COCO database. So the YOLO algorithm is trained on this COCO database. These are the pretrained models. So you can download the images from this link. A link is given below this image. You can have this link and download the images, and you can train your own YOLO algorithm on this data set, and you can make another improved version of YOLO algorithm for object detection of it.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So maybe I have missed something, but sir, how we initially detect an object from an image? So that's what I am trying to figure out.
Yeah, these two slides.
Sir, an object like an plain image is
given. Object means what? Object
there are a lot of objects, no, sir. Like for every object there is a class. But I want to ask for initially how we detect an object.
Yeah. Here you can consider. I think you have understood this slide. Encoding a single bounding box.
Yes, sir. The bounding box I have understood, but I am asking that after we divide an image into different parts, and mm-hmm. we use different like bounding box for each to identify an object. But initially, how we detect an object?
No. We first make a pretrained model. Okay. We need to make a model first. YOLO pretrained model. Okay. For that, we need large number of objects. We need large number of images. Okay. So after making the pretrained model, then we can take a random sample or random example or random image, and that will fit to the YOLO implementation. So here YOLO implementation is nothing but the convolutional neural network implementation. Okay. So by changing the convolutional layer or pooling layers, we can have this YOLO implementation. Now whenever there will be some random image for detection, okay, suppose we are going for a face detection. Now that face image will fit to the YOLO implementation, that is the convolutional neural network, and this convolutional neural network will give us a tensor, okay, and that will specify this vector, that is S by S into 5B plus C. Okay, so this
yes, that technicality I got, but my main concern is we have an training image like which we have input the using the COCO, the object image we have put in our system, the mm-hmm. CNN. Then after when we input an a new image or a testing image,
so okay, then, let me explain. When you feed an image into the convolutional neural network, that is YOLO implementation, okay, so that will give us three parameters. One is the bounding box, okay, one is the label, another is the confidence probability.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Hello. Yes, sir.
So we have got these three values.
Yes, sir.
One is the bounding box. So this bounding box is automatically generated by convolutional neural network. That means when we configure the convolutional neural network such a way that convolutional neural network gives us these three values. One is the predicted bounding box, another is the confidence probability, and another is the label. Okay, then we can go for the comparison, the estimated or predicted bounding box with ground truth, and then only that this union over intersection measures will come. Okay, whenever we got these three values, then only this measures union over intersection will come. Then we can calculate the area of intersection, and then we calculate area of union, and whenever we divide the area of intersection by area of union, that will give us the union over intersection. And
sir,
for yes,
you can continue, sir.
For the predicted bounding box, that means there will be a number of predicted bounding box for a single object. Okay, now for the bounding box, when we get this union over intersection value is high, that means the matching probability is high. Okay, then only we can say that bounding box, that predicted or estimated bounding box, will contain the entire object or the most of or the maximum part of the object. That is why here we are having three classifications: poor classifications, good classification, and excellent classification. Excellent classification, the predicted bounding box will coincide with the ground truth box. Okay, but in case of the good classification, in this classification, the predicted bounding box, so most of the part of the object will be found in the predicted bounding box. That is why it is called the good classification. But in case of poor classification, only a small part of the object, that is the maximum part, is excluded. Small part of the object will be found or will be detected in the predicted bounding box or estimated bounding box. So that will not be coincide with, or it will not be closer to the ground truth. But in case of excellent classification, the predicted bounding box or estimated bounding box will coincide with the ground truth. And the internal and the internal operations that are going through into a convolutional neural network, so that will be discussed later.
Okay? Yes, that's what I want to like.
Yeah.
I wasn't unable to understand from getting an image, then CNN do some magic, and then we get the probability. Is that
yes,
so?
At the beginning of the class, when the class started, in the first class, I told you that if time permits, then I will discuss about CNN. Okay.
So without that, how can we implement our own algorithm?
This is available in the OpenCV. You can have the libraries from OpenCV and get your own YOLO implementation. You can customize the available algorithm. Okay, pretrained model is already available. There are so many pretrained models on a number of databases. Okay, so you can,
sir,
have
but without
one
understanding the magical box, how can we like get the implementation?
The CNN is the magical box over here. I will explain about that magical box in subsequent classes.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thanks.
Definitely, I will discuss this. Then only you can understand. Otherwise,
yes, that's why it all got messed up.
How that CNN produces these three values. So unless you understand the internal operation of CNN, so you cannot understand how these three values are produced.
So that's why I got confused. Like, we got the UNO, but how we get the like the output, the s into s into 5b plus c.
No,
I don't get that.
Since the pretrained models are available, so what the people are doing, people are using that pretrained models, okay, customize according to their requirements, then they get that implementation for specific application.
Okay,
that means the same object detection algorithm we can use for face detection also. Okay, that means
yes,
for
sir.
That we need to feed large number of faces for training the YOLO implementation or YOLO model. Once we have the YOLO model, we have to train that model, so that model will aware about a number of examples. Okay, and whenever some new example will come, if the new example will be found to be familiar by the YOLO implementation, then that YOLO model will detect that or predict that object or image some class. That means a class label will be assigned or prediction will be made correctly. If the training set is not having that image, then that model is unable to predict that class or predict that image. That is the only difference. That means you need to feed large number of examples to train that model. Otherwise, your model cannot predict the object. Okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I will definitely discuss this convolutional neural network. So at the end of the topics on biometrics, so that you can understand the internal operations of CNN.
Sir, until that, all the algorithm will make like something magical is happening in between, and then we are getting the result.
Only this case, the magical is happening. From the next class, I will again start the topics on biometrics. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, that's all for today. I will let you know when the next class will be conducted. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay.